It's AumSum time.
Hi guys. Can you guess the title of my next video? Hurry up! Write your guess in the comment section below.
What is diabetes?
A rare diamond.
No. Diabetes is a disease in which glucose or sugar levels in our blood remain high.
Is it higher than the Statue of Liberty?
Nah. Most of our food is converted into glucose and released into the bloodstream. Then our pancreas makes insulin. Insulin helps glucose get into the cells. However, in some people, the insulin production is inadequate or it is not used well. Hence, glucose stays and builds up in the blood, increasing the blood glucose level and thus causing diabetes. There are three main types of diabetes. Diabetes type 1 occurs when our immune cells destroy the cells in pancreas, which make insulin, resulting in less or no insulin production. Diabetes type 2 occurs when pancreas cannot produce enough insulin or our bodies cannot use it well. Gestational diabetes occurs in pregnant women. Diabetes can lead to blindness, kidney failure, heart attacks, etc. Hence, diabetic people should always maintain their blood glucose levels. Why can't you use phones on planes?
Cause phones can fall out of the window.
Nah. It might be because portable electronic devices like cell phones and tablets emit radio signals. These signals can interfere with the flight controls. They may also disrupt the communication with the air traffic controllers on the ground. Besides this, cellular towers are miles below the airplane. Hence, cell phones try to emit a stronger radio signal to detect the network. This can increase the possibility of causing interference with the airplane electronic equipment.
Really? I didn't know that.
Hence, portable electronic devices are told to be either turned off or to be kept on airplane mode or flight mode. This prevents the emission of radio signals, thus helping to keep all the onboard equipment working properly. Topic: joints. Why do knuckles pop?
So that when we get bored, we can pop them for time pass.
Nah. A knuckle is a joint in the finger where two bones come together or connect. This joint is filled with a fluid called synovial fluid. Synovial fluid is a viscous fluid containing dissolved gases like oxygen and carbon dioxide. When bones move, the synovial fluid prevents them from grinding against each other.
Wow, it's so amazing.
Indeed, when we stretch or bend our finger, the space between the two bones increases. This causes the synovial fluid to stretch, thus creating low pressure in it. Now, as gases are less soluble at low pressure, the dissolved gases in the synovial fluid undissolve, resulting in the formation of a bubble, which we hear as the pop sound. Topic: ultrasound. Why is ultrasound used in sonar? Hey, looks like you're searching for a treasure hidden in a sunken ship. Why don't you use a sonar? It will emit ultrasounds and help you locate the ship.
You know what? I have a better idea.
No, a music system will make ordinary sound, so it is of no use.
Don't fool me. I know that the music system is the right choice.
See? You're not able to find the ship. Now will you use a sonar? Look, you easily found the ship. Do you know how a sonar could locate the sunken ship? It was because of ultrasound. Ultrasounds are sounds having very high frequencies, which start from 20,000 hertz.
So is ultrasound used in sonar because of its high frequency?
Bingo. You are absolutely correct. Due to its high frequency, an ultrasound can penetrate to a greater depth, thus helping us to locate the depth of the sea, sunken ships, etc.
Huh?
But I'm not able to hear the ultrasound.
It is because human beings can hear sound frequencies from 20 hertz to 20,000 hertz. As ultrasounds have frequencies higher than 20,000 hertz, we cannot hear them.
Hmm.
Huh?